What's something from the 90s you miss? Pre-911 airports. I was moving cross-country and called a friend to bring me my tool set he borrowed so I could put it in my checked baggage. He never showed up and I thought, well, that's that. Sitting on the plane, the stewardess walked up and said, "Are you?" I said, "Yes," and she just handed me my 120-piece tool set complete with hammer, socket wrench, screwdrivers, carpet knife, and explained the friend had arrived at the gate just after I boarded. Even back then I was like, seriously? I remember I was flying home after my first year of college, where I had taken some art classes. When I finally got home I was looking in my backpack and forgot that I had left some art supplies in there, including a couple of box cutters, the weapon used on 9/11. Security said nothing. Another time I was seeing one of my friends off at the airport as they were going to an out-of-state college. I arrived to the airport with my other friend and his little brother, who had brought a toy rifle with him to the airport for some reason. Anyway, we were super late and rushing to the gate so we could say goodbye to my friend who was leaving. The little brother was too small, so my buddy picked him up so we could sprint to the gate. In the process, his brother hands me the toy rifle. So there we are, the three of us running through the airport, and I'm holding what looks like a rifle. This was before the security checkpoint, and I realized this might not look good, but I'm in a rush, so I just chuck the rifle behind some chairs. I literally just threw it behind some airport seats. Nobody said anything, but I'm still surprised security wasn't called. Basically just pre-9/11 in general. Colorful translucent electronics. Oh yay, that purple N64 controller. Being able to act goofy without having anyone record it and share with the world. I don't have any friends that would record just hanging out. I guess that's a perk of being in my 30s. I don't have any friends. Also a perk of being in my 30s. Ugh, agreed. I had to stop drinking with one of my friends because she'd always record everyone doing anything even remotely fun or goofy, and it'd be on Snapchat or Facebook within seconds. Like, I just wanna get a little drunk and dance and have a good time with my friends. I don't want every person I hardly know seeing me let loose. I'll never forget watching a last day of school video from June 2001, and while there's a lot of differences, especially in style and fashion, hands down the biggest difference was the relative novelty all the students and teachers gave to the video camera. Like, only this one guy decided to bring in the camera. There were no phones or other recording devices at the time, so it was so cute seeing someone walk up to him and then their eyes go wide and they say, "Oh, oh, oh, a camera." Being recorded was not the norm. And shoot, dude, I'm in my late 20s still, but June 2001 feels like yesterday to me. Time just effing moves on ya. This change happened fast. Someone posted two photos of the crowd at the Vatican. One for the election of Pope Benedict in 2005 and one for Pope Francis in 2013. No phones vs all phones. Walking 20 minutes to a mate's house, knocking his door, then finding out he's not in. It was like rolling the dice. If I really wanted to hang out with a particular friend and they weren't home, that meant it was time to hop on the bike and ride by the next 4-5 most likely places he would be. Or going to 4-5 houses and getting the crew together. That was always so fun. My son did that with his buddies once. He came home and told me he felt like I probably did as a kid. They had a really good time. Arcades. Big, noisy arcades. Full of actual video games. Whose graphics were 20 times better than what you could get at home. And the machines took coins. Not this bullshit refillable card system that is why I'm more of a blatant ripoff. Oh, the cards are the worst. You have to buy one card per person, or everyone has to stay together to use the card. And each card has an activation fee. Sometimes I miss the internet from the 90s. It was less stressful, if that makes sense. It was far less commercial. People ran the internet, not companies. I miss individual self-made websites. There still isn't quite anything like going through a community made up of a few Envision or vBulletin forums. Everyone there is there because they want to be, based on a specific community. If you see someone on another forum, it's a treat. If one forum is full of idiots, there's probably another. Your PFP is important, and a lot of places had a style to them. Now everything is a refined subreddit and it's all homogenized, and no community has a specific flavor or niche anymore. I'm so glad that the dumbest shy said as a teenager is hidden away on some defunct video game forums under a screen name that isn't even close to my real name. I feel for today's kids, who know that if they ever do anything noteworthy with their lives, Someone will dig through their old tweets and be like, yeah, but look at this, this guy said as a freshman in high school. Movies. A lot my favorite movies are mid-sized thrillers from the 90s. A lot of big actors, but not huge spectacles. That segment is dying out. You have huge blockbusters for international markets, some prestige period pieces, comedies and indies, and then there are TV shows. But the sort of Harrison Ford's Wife is missing. Again, films are severely lacking these days. I miss action movies from back then. I love the identical way bad guys in films get shot down, the little dance before collapsing bloodlessly. I sometimes ask myself if movies from the 90s were so great because they were just a part of my childhood, or they are actually special by objective standards. As you alluded to, I really do think there was a style of film they put out more in the 90s. I can't exactly put my finger on what that style is, though, probably because Harrison Ford keeps injuring himself crashing planes. Saturday morning TV, and with that, waking up a bit too early for the 6 a.m. shows and having to sit through the 700 Club, and that feeling of disappointment when the last cartoon ended and Shudder Golf started. You knew Saturday morning was over when Soul Train came on, Snake as well. Saturday night Nickelodeon with the Mortin shows like Are You Afraid of the Dark, all that, Keenan Kel, Cousin Skeeter, and some of the cast members or the occasional special guest chilling on the big orange couch. I was a huge fan of Nick at Night, when they reran really old sitcoms. I probably wouldn't have enjoyed WandaVision nearly as much if I hadn't been familiar with Bewitched, Dick Van Dyke Show, and others, TGIF Night 2 lol. As weird as it sounds, boredom. Now I have an endless supply of sh to keep my mind occupied. I never find myself wandering out for the sake of finding something to do. Trying to call everyone in my book to find someone to hang out with it. I think part of the problem is that the endless supply of distractions just aren't all that satisfying. They're rarely worth remembering or talking to people about. I don't really feel like I'm living. Just existing. Yeah, since the advent of streaming services, YouTube and online gaming, I've pretty much never been bored unless I'm at work and trying to run down the clock. But boredom has been replaced by existential dread over how I'm spending so much of my time in front of a screen, or how I'm not spending my time in the right way when I do choose to do something not involving games or videos. No lie, I've sometimes found myself listening to a podcast on Spotify, creating music playlists on Tidal, Reddit up on secondary monitor, while intermittently texting a friend. All while waiting for DPSQ on Overwatch. It's too much. This is so spot on, I have nothing to add. Just wanted to put in that I feel this so deeply. The excitement of watching a TV show with your friends at a certain time, and if you missed it, you missed it. We used to have Friends ER night in college. A bunch of us would gather and watch the shows together. Do people even have watch parties for shows anymore? I feel like Game of Thrones was the last gasp for that. We would all gather in my tiny college apartment to watch The Office every week. Good memories. And I believe Game of Thrones was the last time I did that with any friends as well. I wonder if we'll ever do that again. Weird to think that might have been the last time. Makes me think of the Seinfeld finale. My parents had like 4 friends over to watch it, and I just ruined it for them by asking to play Sega the whole time. The UK sitcom Only Fools and Horses had a Christmas Day special that was the event, and everyone watched it. We had an elderly aunt over for Christmas and she talked all the way through it, about nothing. Being social with people felt so different and authentic. My friends would sometimes just drop by to see if I was home to say hi. We could pick up the phone and have our long conversations. It felt like text message cheap, and that the lesser dependence on technology seemed to cultivate more genuine friendships, but that was just my experience. Yeah, I've been thinking about that lately. I see. My 3 best friends a handful of times this year, like 2 or 3 times each. But we're in a group yet, and that's how we stay in touch. It's kinda pacifying. Renting movies at Blockbuster as a family event. It was special and fun. We don't have any streaming or cable, and I like it that way. But I wish I could still have that Blockbuster excitement. I miss not being able to be reached, or being able to reach people. Back then you'd call your friend and it would ring somewhere in their house. If there was no one there, which was common, you'd shrug and just carry on your day. If you just wanted to chill out on your own, you'd just not answer the phone. Now, everyone knows people are never without their phones. I've had people pissed at me because I took an hour to reply to a text. I remember I got a beeper in 1994, cue the drug dealer jokes, and became the communications hub for my group of friends. Gets a page from Steve, hey you beeped me, what's up, is Mike with you, yeah, why, his mom is looking for him and called my house to see if he was here, okay, dude, call your mom, now, everyone knows people are never without their phones. You can solve this by routinely being without your phone for a while. I carry my phone with me, but I generally do not answer it or pay attention to it while I am out of the house, and all of my friends and family know not to expect immediate responses from me. Accordingly, none of them do. I find it a much less stressful way to live than feeling like I'm chained to this small device in my pocket. I remember feeling good about myself. If you were good at something, people would let you know that, and you also always knew that one kid who was exceptional at a specific game, that teen who could do awesome tricks on the skate, or a friend who had the most beautiful handwriting you've ever saw, and other things like that. That was special to you because they felt that they meant something and they actually did, because you could be watching that level of ability for the last time on your life. Today everything has been mastered by a lot of people constantly displaying it on the internet. We have 24/7, one click away, video footage we can play over and over of them being incredibly awesome on it, and I think it frustrates people. You're never really satisfied on what you're doing because deep down you know you'll probably be just another one in 7 billion, and you're not really paying attention to people anymore either, because it really doesn't matter, whatever it is that they're doing. You can watch someone doing it better on the internet how many times you want, anyway. Things used to mean something. I miss that. That sums it up nicely. Nothing killed my self-worth quite like actually realizing how hopelessly outclassed I truly was. What you said about video games hit home. In 2008, I thought I was pretty good at Halo Combat Evolved. One friend mentioned that getting through the library level on Legendary without dying was impossible. I told him I thought I could do it. So he and some friends came over after school to see if it could be done. I managed to complete the level without dying, and without any speedrunning strategies because I had no idea what that was at the time. Not only did I beat the level, I only got shot a handful of times. My friends were shocked. Phone calls were made to other friends to tell them what they saw. I felt on top of the world that day. Now, you just Google it and find tons of people are capable of it and so much more. The enjoyment of your friends' skills for what they were just kind of fell off, like you said. The internet being made up of AOL chat rooms instead of just being Reddit, Facebook, Twitter. I miss the lack of interconnectivity. Like, my summer camp friends were different from school friends, and I didn't really see my summer camp friends outside of July and August. Everything was distinct. When I went from Western New York to New Jersey to see family, it was basically like being on another planet. I think I like everything being more connected, but that sense of distinctness is something I miss. I never thought of this. I had my school friends, and my taekwondo friends. I invited them over once together for a birthday party and it was incredibly weird. Like a crossover special. I get weirded out when I post something and it spawns a conversation where my people pools start to mix. Like, my extended family people start conversing with my old college buddies, who are conversing with local friends, who are conversing with work associates, who are conversing with that dude who I'm pretty sure I've met at one point, and we have a few mutual friends but I have absolutely no clue who he is. It's especially stressful when the conversation veers into divisive or heated topics. I feel this way about shopping. As shallow as that might sound, I feel like you can get any product anywhere now. I don't mean schlock appliances, obviously that's fine, but little knickknacks and decorations are now ubiquitous. The interconnectivity of shopping has made everything interchangeable and uniqueness is dead. It used to be that if you went to a different area of the world or even your country and found something cool, you could bring it back and feel like you had something special. I don't even want to buy decorations anymore, because it all feels not only mass-produced, but you can't even trust little stores with curios. You can definitely find the same stuff with an internet search. I now literally wait until craft fairs to buy any decorations for my home, and make sure it's something that person made and not something they are just middlemanning. I got a house in 2019 and it's still only half decorated, but to me that's preferable to filling it with stuff that you get at Target that everyone else has. I don't judge people for having mass-made things. but it just feels so soulless to me and isn't what I want at my house. Luckily houseplants are always unique individuals, so I have a lot of those lol. Friday night at Blockbuster renting movies for the weekend. No social media bullsh. My youth. Actual 90s aesthetic. It was extreme and alternative. Not family friendly, wacky or dystopian like a lot of people think when they see an 80s aesthetic. Example, the entire aesthetic of Nickelodeon in the 90s. Slime and extreme sh, I forgot about the green slime. That seemed a part of everyday life if you watched Nickelodeon. Who's getting it today? The secret slime action is being Danny Tamborelli. Danny Tamborelli, Little Pete, did an IAMA like 10 years ago where he talked about the culture at Nickelodeon in the early 90s. It's been a long time, but I remember him saying they basically considered themselves the anti-Disney channel because most of the writers, directors, showrunners, etc. were younger and more alternative and wanted to push the limits, rather than taking the wholesome, family-friendly route. He also says Toby Huss, Artie the Strongest Man in the World, gave him his first cigarette. The late 90s in wrestling is referred to as the Attitude Era, but I feel like that's a good description for pop culture in general at the time. When people who posted meaningless bullshit on the internet were considered weirdos instead of celebrities worth building a cult around. Slap bracelets. Just being perfectly content slap in your wrist for hours on end. It was a simpler time. Being considered smart, not weird, for refusing to make your IRL identity known online. Thank you. When I was an early teen in the late 90s, I was told over and over to never put your real information out there. It blows my mind that that is completely normal now. It's unreal how blithe some people have gotten toward privacy. My brother's a high school teacher, and a few years ago he caught a girl in his class live streaming herself just sitting there, learning. He asked her to stop, and noticed that there were 15 people apparently watching her on the stream, and suggested that the kinds of people who would watch a 16-year-old girl sitting in class are maybe not the kinds of people she should want watching her. The girl's response was a confused "why not?" I still cannot get over the fact some of you have your actual real-life faces' names directly in your profile. I can't tell you how weird and uncomfortable I find that. The innocence of the time. We still played outside but had some awesome multiplayer games that you played together in the same room. The world seemed to be heading for better and better things. Then 2001 happened. The internet. Post-90s folks, you've got no idea. It was just so different. Web 1.0 was a wild west. Video games that aren't online and not having to sign in 2-3 accounts to play any game. I have my computer set to manually connect to the internet. I still have to sign into Steam to play a game that isn't dependent in an active connection. Thankfully there is an offline mode for Steam, but I shouldn't have to sign in the first place if the game doesn't require a password. Then the game makes you wait for a 25GB update to download and install after you sign in. Remember when the PC magazines came with a CD full of mods and demos? Some of the Half-Life mods were amazing. Dial-up was our only way to play multiplayer, which even back in the early days games like Delta Force and Counter-Strike seemed more fun than the games now. Maybe I'm just old, but those were great times. I still ride my bike daily and do wheelies and giggle like I'm 10 again. No social media, not always being available, friends just randomly stopping by your house, much less political divisiveness. Yeah, friends randomly stopping by was awesome. Nowadays nobody you care about will ring your doorbell unannounced. Makes The Sims feel unrealistic to me with how many people visit unannounced lol. Hearing rock and roll on the radio that wasn't the same old classic rock. It's crazy that with YouTube and the internet we have much, much more variety and quantity of artists' songs, yet the radio playlist seems even smaller than it used to be. During the 90s, I was aged 17-27, so those were some good years for me. My oldest was born in the early 2000s. So when I look back at the 90s, all I remember is freedom. Free from most adult responsibilities. Free from social media. Free from bullshit politics. They were there for sure, but you literally had to look for them. Lol. Free from a general miasma of fear coming from the media. When I think back, all I remember is sunshine. The lack of a weight bearing down on my shoulders all the time and the sweet sounds of amazing music. While I miss it, I am just grateful that I got to experience it. In the 90s, I was 4 to 14. Being a kid in the 90s was awesome. but I do wish I'd been a little older and able to better appreciate how amazing the 90s were. At the time, I thought it was just life and didn't realize that decade would become widely regarded as the best decade of my lifetime. So far. The original release of Pokemon cards. Those were the effing best. My nieces begin to Pokemon now, and she just got a shload of cards for her birthday. Made me want to start collecting them again. But I look up the packs from my youth and their astronomical prices. Ah well. Clearly Canadian sparkling water. It came back not long ago but was limited release and I could never get any. I miss the internet being fun and optimistic. I genuinely feel like the internet has gone from the most important and greatest achievement of humanity to something that might have been a mistake during my lifetime. It's really sad because a global communications network should be a great thing for everyone. The internet has gotten really heavy and depressing in the past few years. Even 10 years ago the internet felt much more lighthearted. I miss message boards. Find a niche interest and everyone there was excited about it. It all shifted to Facebook and Reddit and these places are far less personal and way more toxic. I actually made friends on those old boards and visited people. Reddit, I have zero attachment to anyone here. Why I post so infrequently? Optimism. It was a pretty happy decade. The Cold War was over. The economy was booming. Technology seemed to be offering us solutions before we even knew we had a problem. The products of pop culture almost never dwelled on dystopia or decline. Air travel was about as dangerous as bus travel. Acid rain and the hole in the ozone layer were problems of the decade before that seemed to have been fixed. And climate change was still called global warming and was not nearly so front and center in how people talked about the future. All in all, the 90s were a pretty solid decade. Family owned convenience stores. Diners. Burger joints. Ice cream parlors. Cafes. Bookstores. Delis. Etc. Even small neighborhood grocery stores. And independent music venues. Seems like I'm talking about the 50s but in the 90s these places still existed. In my hometown most of them are completely gone and were replaced by generic corporate chains or condos. The ones that are still around are struggling to stay afloat and compete. I'm glad I got to enjoy them while they existed but also realized how much I took them for granted. Full-size frosted strawberry Pop-Tarts. They're, like, half the thickness these days. That and eating them while watching back-to-back episodes of Saved by the Bell on Saturday mornings. Good times. When you went to a rave, which were mostly all underground then, you were taught about the responsibility of researching drugs on a Rowid. Mystery. Not having read everything. The feeling that anything could happen. Because you haven't learned read seen so many things. Things being super fresh. How uninhibited. Freshly uncensored and creative people were because they weren't constantly preoccupied with their social media presence. Being attacked online. People diminish their energy now tremendously because of social media. It isn't even close to the same universe. People pretend not to be uptight and suffocated in that way. To pretend to vibe. But it will never stop looking put onto me. Being able to afford a decent 1BR apartment on the top floor of a building in a nice, trendy neighborhood of Seattle on $28k a year. My rent was $550 a month for several years. I miss getting a new album from a band, in cassette form, popping it into my Walkman and just exploring my neighborhood listening to the same songs over and over. Now with music streaming services and access to all of the music ever created I actually almost never listen to new music. And when I do, I feel silly listening to it over and over. Even songs I like these days, I rarely remember the words to and I never even remember track titles. It used to be, if I got a Green Day album, I listened to it until I memorized all of the track names and all of the lyrics. Simpler times and more free time I guess. The world being so much smaller. Sure there are a lot of really great things about being able to talk to anyone. Anywhere at any time but the appreciation of how big and impressive the world really is because of how hard it was to contact people in different countries and the bonds you formed with people in your closer community is something that is gone forever. Affordable housing and the non-existence of social media. Pogs. Tamagotchis. The music. The original Jolt Cola. Not knowing Cosby was such a piece of sh. Being young relatively healthy. My grandpa. The sense of security resulting from the collapse of the Soviet Union in 911 not having happened yet.